Who are they to say that just cause we black, we can't have that, can't be that, can't achieve that? Who are they to say that statistically we can't compete with the Ivy League, who use our ancient knowledge to try to lead? Who dares to compare these races when we gave birth to all these different color faces? Who? How dare them even attempt to try to judge who we are? Only the Most High can judge who we are, and he says that we are infinitely burning stars. And these scars that we wear bear this truth to be self-evident. So fuck the president and his associates, cause when the going gets tough, they hide out at Camp David, protected, while we're exposed to these terroristic elements. 9/11 holds the evidence, it's evident, as these catastrophic winds blow. The top American 2% ends grow off the blood, sweat, and tears of these Negroes. Heroes, they left to fend for themselves. Barbara Bush thinks it's the best thing for their health. She's fucking shameless after all the nameless atrocities against our race. I can see Sojourner Truth turning in her grave, just itching to smack her fucking face. I think it's time we separate ourselves from them and watch their fucking devastation. Shit, I think it's time we unite and build our own nation and regain our cultural liberation. Cause it ain't like we asking for more than we do. It's the least they could do after reneging on our 3 acres and a mule, stealing our inventions, raping our women, watering down our genetic soup. It's inconceivable the evil men do. I said it's inconceivable the evil men do. But after all their schematic plots to conquer and divide, niggas, we do not die. And after all their little plans to commit genocide, niggas, we do not die. And after all they half-truths and whole lies, niggas, we do not die. We get high, we multiply, by any means we gon' survive. And the ones they thought they killed, best believe they're still alive. Whether it's Rita, Katrina, earthquakes or tsunamis, their spirits are still alive and they form in the Most High's armies.
May I help you?
Hi, I'd like to get a hairpiece.
Excuse me?
I'd like to get a hairpiece, please.
Would you like information?
Well, yes. I need some information because I'd like to tell you some information.
Okay, hold on 1 second.
Hello, who are you looking for?
Hi, I just want to know a little information on a hairpiece.
Okay.
The other night I was out at a basketball game with my whole family.
Right.
And I only asked this guy in front of me to just sit down a bit so I could see. And he beat me unmercifully. He beat me very badly, and my hairpiece fell off.
My God.
And it fell into this, like, onto the floor there, and all of a sudden everyone's laughing at me and my family as well. And I look up on the screen, and they had me on the screen with my hair laying on the floor. And it was awful because when he beat me, my teeth were also in my hairpiece.
Your teeth ended up in your hairpiece?
Yes, and I just want something. My hairpiece is always embarrassing me in front of my family and friends. I just need to have, like, a transplant, a weave or something.
Okay, would you like to come in for a consultation?
Yes. Anything would be fine just so we can get on the road to recovery here. Because this is mentally killing me as well.
This is hurting you mentally?
Yes, it's really getting on my nerves.
Okay, how can we help you out then?
I just need some kind of, like, little fruity weave or some kind of, like, blonde basket or something that you'll put on top of my head.
A line basket?
No, a blonde basket. Like, some kind of hair weave, kind of, like a jivey kind of thing.
All right, I think we can help you out with that. But basically, you'd have to come in for a consultation. Oh. We can take a look at your hair and see what exactly...
Okay. Then I'll come in as soon as possible.
Okay, can I take your name down?
My name is... Revenge!
People! Evil people!